Because if they cannot commit to what they are going to do, then I would never be able to see the value in the coaching, right? So this is the most important part, right? To actually get their commitment. Okay? So, let's do a role play. However, now the role play will switch a little bit because now it's a case of doing a career conversation, right? So the two of you still, but let me give you the context. So the context is, this person is a high performer, right? Identified to move from a senior manager to a, sorry, from a senior executive to a manager in say 6 months, which is exactly the situation of people that you'll be dealing with, right? And you have now been invited to do a coaching session, right? So the rest of us, what we do is we take down 2 points. Number one, what did the coach do well? And number two, look out for what can the coach do differently. And of course, automatically, let's try to keep that four quadrants at the back of our mind. Okay? Right. So who would like to play the role of a coach and who wants to play the role of coaching?
So actually what would you like to achieve at the end of our conversation today? Basically more in terms of your happily in terms of your career progression.
I want a clarity on how do I move my career upwards.
Let's ponder so in your era of work. So what do you enjoy most? Which area or what do you enjoy most?
I enjoy most that I'm able to for example a program able to actually roll out in the company.
This in terms of
execution, project
implementation.
You own the head to tail lah, from initiate the idea, propose, get buy-in, execution, and see it through.
What else?
excitement about working with people, learning new things along the way.
Get back to your earlier question. So how would you think that in terms of moving forward, what do you think, what are the resources or help that you need to, for you to move to the next level? Okay. That would that mean you help you in terms of
I think the more important is add value to my own development, capabilities, keep learning new things and exploring new adventure into new area that I've never tried before. So it's at the same time it's to enhance my skill sets.
So you have mentioned that you find certification in terms of leading a project and executing a project, meeting people and so forth. So let's think about to add value. So which are the areas you think that you may not have much exposure and you want to learn more or zoom into that?
For the time being, coaching is one of the programs that I started to embark on. So that is already considered ongoing. I have identified my IDP, have also worked out what are the action plans that I want to do. So there are three, but I think basically there are three, but only managed to carry out one for the time being. So there are two more that still wait and see what is.
So you would say that
coaching?
Yeah. May I know, would you like to share with me the two IDP that you wish to achieve?
Yeah, sure. The second one is be part of the Toastmaster, enrolled in Toastmaster. But that one I actually put on hold. The third one is job shadow with another of my colleague who is handling the FMCG. But that one also not seeing it happening due to the business outlook. So that project is also not working.
The lesson, so apart from, maybe the other two is due to circumstances, KIV. So let's explore what other things that you think you would like to explore or gain value or enhance your skills and knowledge in addition to coaching. It may not be, maybe I will not want to restrict excuse, maybe in terms of experiences or projects or some other new portfolio that you want to
achieve. I found I'm lacking of some, like now the advance of the technology, the PowerPoint presentation is unlike my generation. It has actually come to a very scenario where I find I'm actually quite lacking. So, and also because I have staff that's doing for me, so I rely a lot from them, which I think I would want to actually brush up also the presentation skill.
So, okay, so you have now zooming to coaching and also improving your presentation skills to upgrading your IT knowledge and prepare the presentation slides. Okay, as for in
terms of coaching, so moving forward, how would you enhance your skills? Have you come up with plans to enhance your coaching skills?
Coaching skill. I've committed to clock in 20 hours, which I'm almost there. And now embarking into coaching someone outside from my organization. That is also, which I admit my commitment to it. That is coaching. And the one on the improving your skills in
preparing slides.
Preparing slides. So how do you think you will be able to achieve it?
How do I think?
The fastest is to maybe get someone to guide me or learn myself.
So is there any other, okay, the miss is on the job training, probably maybe you learn it from yourself, no? What else? What kind of other support that you need to achieve to improve your skills or help you to enhance to the next level? Business recovery period. So what is the role to help the
company?
The company to move to a more stable role. So, okay, glad to hear all this from you. So, perhaps can I get your commitment for our next, maybe let's say, how would you continue with this conversation? Would you like to meet up, say, in a month's time? Okay. So what would be your commitment that you will do, say, within this month? Okay.
I think in terms of the PowerPoint, the slides things, because I will need to schedule time or to request from myself to put time into perhaps once a week, sit down with me and so I have to prepare something with animation, with music, with video, so that is to have something before I meet you. And also on the HR trend, I can do it on my own pace because there are many webinars that is free, that if the topics is interested, as well as you can log in and collect myself.
How about in terms of enhancing the coaching skills?
Coaching skill, yes. By this week, I will be completing my 20 hours. And also by September, I will start the coaching with a colleague outside my company.
Good. So we shall meet up again in 1 month's time.
Okay.
Right.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks. All right. Oh, all
right.
Starting, we saw a big start. After that, it became very
slow. Engine,
that's right. That's right.
Tell me, ask a very good question.
Some of your questions towards the end was fantastic. The reason why initially you were stuck, right, is because I think everyone might have forgotten a very important formula, which is what is LSB? So she, on two occasions, I was telling CY, I said, hey, I hold her opportunity to, you know, further. So she already told you she wants to improve herself in some area, right? But you did not go direct into asking her further about it and continue being curious. But you were sort of struggling at the back of your mind, what's the next question to ask? So if I were you, I would just ask her, June, so it's interesting that you want to develop yourself and better yourself, you know, in the area of coaching. How are you going to do that? What are you going to do? Suppose if somebody is there to guide you. So one point she said, I will get someone to guide me. Right? Because you are the manager, right, and you are the leader, you could have been curious to say, sure, that would be wonderful. Who is going to be giving you that input? Who is going to be giving you the guidance? So like that, towards the end, right, she will have like, okay, I'm supposed to go and talk to Lawrence and learn coaching skills from him. I'm supposed to go and call up Sunil and ask him to help me with career coaching skills and the tools. I'm supposed to speak to Grace and I'm supposed to do this. Like that, she will have a very clear action plan moving forward. Alright? So that was the part which I thought, I think we sort of need to remind ourselves on this. Because if we don't do this, you know what happened? We will try to go all over the direction. Right? So I realized slowly you started becoming very good at this. Right? And towards the end you managed to enter. Now if I could give you an idea.